Dr. Kathy Schanzer, and I'd like to talk to you about dry eyes, in particular dry eyes attributable to LASIK. I've got a diagram here of a LASIK flap, so you can see the cornea. This is a LASIK flap. I can tell that this is a flap that's made by a femtosecond laser by the precision of the cut. This is the iris, which is the color part of your eye, and in this particular patient, it's obviously a blue eye. This would be the pupil, and then the lens would be back behind it. Now, why is this important? Because when we're cutting the flap with a femtosecond laser, we can actually design how thick we want it. And the thinner the flap, the few corneal nerves that we're cutting, as opposed to a blade, which tends to make a thicker flap and cut more corneal nerves. Well, why is that important? Because the corneal nerves help us to have a feedback loop that goes actually from the eye to the brain to say that the eye is dry, and that sends a message back to the lacrimal gland to produce those tears. If those nerves are cut, it can't send that message to the brain and then subsequently to the lacrimal gland to produce more tears. So the more nerves that are cut, the drier the eye is going to tend to be. These people will often have symptoms like foreign body sensation, halos, difficulty with night driving, and the eye becomes uncomfortable. And either blade or bladeless can have dry eye, but it tends to be more severe in the thicker flap with the blade.